Hi, Kyle here with FCP Euro and our project CLK 550. We've recently upgraded the brake system on the CLK, and today we'll be flushing the brake fluid with ROWE's 0.4 LV, or low viscosity, 0.4 brake fluid. We'd like to thank ROWE for sponsoring the video today, and we urge you to check out ROWE's entire line of MB-approved fluids for Mercedes vehicles, including their HC synthetic engine oil, their coolant, and their transmission fluid. Let's get started. To get to the CLK's brake fluid reservoir, we've got to remove this plastic drip tray. So there are just two clips holding it in place. Just got to turn them. There we are. And lift up. Slide it out. And now you've got access to the brake fluid reservoir. You're just going to remove that cap, which just unscrews. And I'm just using tools we have lying around to extract the fluid. So we've got the performance tool fluid extractor pump. I'm just going to dump it in the reservoir, and I've got a motive bleeder bottle over here. And I'm just trying to get rid of some of the old fluid that's in the reservoir. All right, so we've got the reservoir empty. Now I'm going to get a little bit of the ROWE brake fluid into our brake fluid reservoir. And then we will set up the motive brake bleeder. We've got our motive bleeder. I believe it's part number MOT0100. And I'm going to add about a liter and a half, maybe 2 liters of fluid to our bleeder. Using the motive bleeder allows brake bleeding to be a one-person job, which is extremely convenient. All right, so that's about a liter and a half of fluid. Now we're going to connect the power bleeder to the reservoir. The motive bleeder cap fits most ATE reservoirs, like what you'll see on BMWs, Mercedes, some Audis, some Saabs. What you want to do is make sure that you're very tightly connected to the reservoir. If you're not, when you build pressure, it will backflow out of the reservoir and it'll end up on the paint of the car, which is the last thing you want. All right, so this is sealed pretty tightly. I'm gonna try to get about 20 pounds of pressure on here, and then we'll get started with bleeding at each of the calipers. So I'm at 15 pounds actually, which should be sufficient, and we're gonna get started. All right, so we've got our bottle here to capture the old brake fluid. I've got a 9mm gooseneck wrench. I'd actually recommend, if you have one, to use a 9mm flare nut, just something that's gonna get all the way around here. And we'll get set up. And what I'm looking for, I don't really care about bubbles. I don't expect to see a lot of bubbles because we're not bleeding. I'm looking for a color change as we flush. We're going to go from a dark fluid to a much lighter color. Fluid's beginning to dribble into the capture bottle. It's doing so kind of slowly, so I'm going to increase my pressure at the motive bleeder to 20 pounds. I can see the fluid beginning to fill up in the catch bottle. All right, so we've got a good amount of fluid out of the caliper on this side. We're gonna go ahead and move over to the driver's side now. So we're gonna close that up, remove our brake line, remove the wrench, put the dust cover back on, and we're all set. All right, so as the last step, we've got to release the pressure at the bleeder bottle so that we can cap off our reservoir. So we're just gonna slowly open that up. You can hear the pressure begin to release. And then I'm going to unscrew at the reservoir. So we're gonna cap that off. Put our drip tray back on. And we're all set. So we've completed the procedure of flushing the brake fluid on our project CLK 550. The procedure that we perform today is going to be similar on most Mercedes models, excluding Mercedes models with the Sensitronic brake system. I'd like to thank ROWE for sponsoring our video today. And if you like what you've seen, hit the like button and be sure to subscribe. Thanks again for watching.